What's up, everybody? Brett here, back today playing some more Total War Warhammer 2 on our Vortex campaign with Markus Wulfhart. And as things stand, we're very close to stabilizing, guys. We royally pissed off the entire jungle of Lustria. We are level 5 condemned. The enemies we fight today will be incredibly powerful. We've got lots of things to do. We've got this oatmeal guy is waiting on the wings here to try and attack one of our major strongholds. It's pretty beefy though. I think we can hold it, depending on how good the AI is at sieging. We've got this stack here that's going to look to eradicate the Blue Vipers once and for all. They've been a major thorn in our side. We've got some new units that we can use to retrofit this army, which we're going to do as soon as possible. But first, and of course we have some levels, but first things first, we need to beat Luthor Harkin in open field, which is something we're going to do. We could let him sit here and try and siege us. It may only take him a turn to do it, but every turn that you waste in campaign is pretty precious. So what we're going to do is we're going to attack them, and we're going to get our garrison, we're going to get this small army that we have. And I know that we can beat these guys. It's really just a matter of how much we're going to lose due to the super jacked up weapon strength that they have compared to what they normally have anyway. And the leadership is probably the biggest issue when you're fighting the undead. So normally you would expect these guys to crumble pretty soon after being engaged upon, but in this instance, they just won't. They're chevroned up. You can see here, especially all these mad bombers. They're super annoying. Not mad bombers, but bombers. And they also have increased leadership from playing on a harder difficulty, plus the increased 10 leadership from us being condemned. So fighting undead like that, that feels basically unbreakable, is rough. So our reinforcements are coming from this side, so we want to deploy with them. This is a pretty beautiful hill if we could take it, but I think we're going to have to settle for this little outcropping here. So let's make a front line with these units. And also remember that these are units that we don't want to lose because they're units that we pay for. The garrison, however, we could lose a ton of those guys. That doesn't matter. Sorry to say to them. They are much, much more expendable than our guys. But we're going to get them in here as soon as possible. We've got our Archlector. We've got our Empire Captain. We're going to have two of those for this battle. Looking pretty tough. If you've never seen an Archlector before, they're really cool. With their hammers. Alright, some handgunners on the high ground. And yeah, that's about all we can do for now. Let's just, as soon as we can, we're going to need to get our reinforcements in to position to defend us. And the best thing to do in this situation is just grab them. Just grab them and move them forward. And as they're moving forward, you could start to put them in hot groups and things like that. Main thing is just to get them moving in the direction that they need to go. These guys, we know they're going to be in a hot group together. But let's perhaps go and get them on the other side of this formation. Our range tools. Let's get them in like a group 3. And we can put them here, maybe. And, alright. Now we've got our artillery, which we don't need to move very much because they're going to be in range just about instantly. I don't know if I did that quite as I wanted to. No, not quite. But that should be good enough to stretch in front of our front line. You know what? Let's go here to here. That looks a little better to me. And if we can get these Outriders to start shooting at these Fellbats, they have a mortar as well. I can see it over here. They've got Luthor Harkin on foot. They've got tons of bloated corpses, and we're going to want to snipe those out as soon as possible. But for now, if we can pick off these Fellbats, that would be great. But like I said, their leadership is going to be so good. Yeah, and here goes the mortar. You know what? And we should just be shooting them like that. Let's run, Outriders. Run, run. Yeah, we don't want their one group of handguns to be shooting at us. We can get out of here with minimal losses. And we'll pull the Fellbats into our handgunners. Go ahead and do that. And we'll turn our handguns to start shooting at them. And what we're going to try and do is use these Outriders to crush. Yeah, let's actually engage with our halberds before these Morghouls get a chance to engage with our swordsmen. We do not want them to engage swordsmen. That is a bad trade for us because they'll just be healing the whole time. Alright, and they're shooting over the heads of our units. That's great. But now we need to get rid of those guys. And because everything they have is a bomber, look at that damage. We can't just sit here. We have to actually move forward and engage with them. Let's move up. Make sure this bloated corpse doesn't kill us. It's going to start charging in a second. Shoot him. We need to back up. That bloated corpse is quite dangerous. Whatever we got to do, they got to go. Okay, let's send in the really hurt halberdiers and let them get blown up. No. Okay, yeah, that we lost about as much as I expected there. And now they're casting spells also. We're losing a ton. And we'll use our reserves to kind of plug the gap. Make sure this guy doesn't ever make it in. That went very well. It looks like we managed to destroy the Morghouls and the bloated corpses, which is good. We've got our lord in here fighting Felbats. Let's get the spearmen in there as well. These archers can back up. And let's back up with our outriders as well. What we really want to do is go up and around with the outriders. Let's shift. That's a little bit too wide of an arch there. But they're going to have to turn and engage us. We'll get our spearmen in. And let's actually also send our Empire Captain forward. Alright, come on guys. That's pretty brutal. We're not quite able to stop them from throwing on us. And Luthor Harkin is still alive and well. He's got 52 kills. And let's send our Outriders into melee. Luckily, some of our stuff is rallying. Keep backing up. We don't want them to get any more volleys off on us. We're holding, guys. This is not an easy battle. It's not an easy battle. Not that it's not an easy battle to win, because I think you know, if you've got some skill, you should be able to win this battle. But that is to say that this is an easy battle to lose a lot. Now that the mortar's shut down, that's excellent. Let's put them on that target there. Get some units over there. Let's take them off guard mode so they'll chase. And the way to kill Luthor is almost really not to engage him. Yeah, engaging him was a bit of a mistake perhaps. Our best bet is just to go ahead and kill everything that's not him. Archers there, very good. Let's get our handguns going there. And then he'll start to crumble due to army losses once we manage to do that. And just like that, there's not much left for him. Everything appears to be crumbling. And we should take this pretty handily. It's really just a matter of, did we lose any of the units that we bought and paid for? Here we go, everything's crumbling. Down they go, and at this point, when everything's crumbling like that, the leadership bar is zero. You'll notice that Luthor Harkin isn't actually dying, he's a vampire, he regenerates. You just gotta engage and melee with him, and his health will just start to, like, absolutely chunk. To watch. Let's just get the Outriders in there and see if my hypothesis is true. Is there anything else on the battlefield?
Yes, sir, quickly.
Get in there, buddy. It probably needs to go. He needs to, like, not be confident in the battle that he's engaged in.
Outriders.
Pretty annoying. He can he can kite us a little bit here if he wants. And the mortars are now joining the fight. Take a look at Luthor, for those of you who've never seen him. The Pirate King. As he turns and shoots. He is crumbling. He has a disrupted ability on his melee attack, so he lowers physical resistance and increases your miscast chance. You really don't want to let him get onto your casters, if you can help it. Let's fast forward here, there's enough of this. Come on, Luthor, you gotta go, buddy. He's like a kid at a McDonald's ball pit. It's like, it's time to go. You gotta get out. We'll send the Outriders to start taking shots at him. We'll take them off of guard mode so they just keep advancing. And there we go. That was the real army losses. I don't know why. His leadership is just so jacked up from all those buffs that... borderline unbreakable Luthor Harkin. Yeah, guys, and we were, of course, numerically outnumbered. We managed to minimize the casualties from these bloated corpses. One of them got in, but it only destroyed a group of halberdiers that was basically dead already. And they were garrison units, so they replenished in a few turns. And guys, I am still recovering from being sick. I'm not 100% by any means. Whether that be like in my play or in my commentary, I'm doing my best. I hope you appreciate that. For those of you who don't know, basically I caught a stomach bug from my son who brought that home. My wife also had it. Lots of vomitus and other terrible things. But unfortunately for me, I have pre-existing medical conditions that made it especially difficult. But I am recovering. I am better today. I just went on like a 1 mile walk just to test. And I almost threw up, but I didn't. I made it the whole little short mile around the block, but I'm getting there. Maybe tomorrow I'll be 100%. Who knows? But this is the trait we gain for killing a unique legendary lord. And it's 1 down, 10 to go. Although a deadly foe has been defeated, one has to wonder if all his personalities have been slain. Defeated Luthor Harkin. And he gets a permanent 15% magic resistance and plus 10 leadership fighting at sea, which is not useless because we may in a bit send him out to go to sea and start taking on, you know, random pirate groups and, you know, accessing all the treasure that's out there. Now, something I noticed when I loaded this up, because I was kind of looking at the game yesterday to see what the kind of the state of our playthrough was, they changed ports back. So check this out. Ports were worthless, and they just had an update this morning, like right before I started playing, and ports are back to their normal income. I'm happy about that. People complained a lot. Maybe people complained a little too much. But I'm still happy that they changed it back because they were basically worthless before. And it sucks because upgrading ports is a part of us gaining acclaim for this playthrough. So we wanted them. You know, we want to upgrade our ports. The expedition is eager. All right, let's see what else we've got. We got the Dawnstone also. That might be better in the hands of Markus, but Markus is one of those guys, if he's getting hit in melee, we're kind of doing it wrong. So maybe it's good on him. We'll leave it on him. We'll let him keep what he kills. And come over here and boost triangulation, so even more missile damage for our whole team. I'm doing this a little bit faster. Sight Beyond Sight is just a kind of a minor upgrade to Eye of Kornos, but it's a good upgrade. It's another 10 meters on the range and another 5%. Missile damage to anyone she stands near. And then here we've already got scavenge. I kind of want to upgrade assassinate. We're not using it now, but there could definitely be a point where we're being harried by a bunch of, you know, weak hero units, and he can just drop out of our party and just wreck them. So he already has his own hero's action success chance boosted, and if we give him assassinate, top it off, he'll be a very powerful you know, campaign instead of a combat-focused hero for us. All right, guys, and now here comes a kind of a cool series of updates that we can do. So let's disband these two swordsmen. Let's disband these two archers. And we can come into here now and grab another unit of greatswords. We'll grab one more halberdier. And two more huntsmen. And recruit them. Good to go. So now we have a much stronger stack than we did previously. No archers with their lower range kind of bogging us down. No more swordsmen getting meat shielded. You know, we can actually stand up and fight with these great swords and halberds. And yeah, this is altogether just a stronger party. The biggest weak link in our party, I think, is these war wagons. I kind of wish this was the mortar variant. Then we'd have a little bit of sieging potential and a little bit of extra range to us. But as it is, we kind of just use them in a safe way.
Markus Wulfhart.
Okay.
So
wow, there's
unflinching.
A lot of stuff here.
Get at me.
And they have a lot of cav. We don't. I don't think we want to attack this, guys. Yeah. That's a lot of biggins. And a lot of cav. I'm not saying we couldn't win. I'm just saying that it would greatly damage us to do that. Interesting. What I would kind of like to do is ambush. Or raid. We could raid, but we have to get into here, and I don't think we're going to be able to get that close. So the problem is, I think if we... Okay, we want to raid along what I think would be their path to attack. So let's say you're going to not raid, ambush. I keep saying the wrong thing. If you're going to ambush, you want to do it in the path that you think the enemy is going to take to get to your nearest asset. And I think if the blue vipers are going to attack me next turn, because they are mustering here, that they're going to do it by walking this way. And the reason I know that is because when I click, see how the AI wants me to go along this path? So if I'm going to ambush, I want to be as close to that path as possible. So I also need to make sure I have, what is it, 50% or is it 25? 25%. I'm going to stay in my own territory so we can continue to recover our forces. Now, bear in mind, we still have regeneration. How many more turns is that going to be for? It doesn't say. Hopefully this isn't the last turn. I don't think that lasts forever. That would be crazy if that lasted forever.
The best.
We've got to be almost out of that. Maybe next turn it'll disappear. Which sucks, because it would be nice to have in this big battle. But we really want to get rid of those blue vipers as soon as possible. If at all possible.
Champion of the
faith. And now we also want to move down here.
True servant of Sigma.
With our boy Aldebrass. And what we're doing is we're getting closer to Tlaxlan, if that's something we want to, someplace we want to go to. But we also need to recruit more forces. And what do we want to recruit? Well, what do we have in reserve? So we have three halberds. So we've got the range game covered. We don't need range. We need some frontliners. And probably the cheaper the better. So let's just go with three swordsmen. And then next turn, we'll be able to just pop these guys in. We don't want to do it now because that just adds unnecessary upkeep. I don't see an army nearby to hurt us.
Time will tell on this one.
So I think we're good. Sure, and we'll go for Iron Disciplinarian. Him plus Conroy, they both have plus 4 public order. So you add that extra plus 1, and they're really locking down this province for us that would otherwise... not be doing so good. We need that corruption to go down. Destroying the vampires will go a long way towards that. But it'll happen. It'll happen soon. Okay, I think we're good. Let's try for a little bit of diplomacy here. We haven't really messed with that yet. The dwarves aren't interested in anything from us. New World Colonies are our defensive friends. We could give them a target. I mean, they have great relationships with Hexoaddle. That's weird, because Hexoaddle looks like it's poised to destroy them. Anything else before we go? I don't think so. Alright, I think that's good enough. What are our current hunter objectives? So raid any region. Ooh, we can pop in like one turn and do that. Nice. Obtaining these resources is easy. We have timber that we're going to retake as soon as possible, and iron straight ahead of us where we're headed to with the blue vipers. Search any ruined settlement. There are tons of ruined settlements here that we can search, whether or not we figure out some ancient lizardmen puzzles. I went back and looked at one of my puzzles that I did, and it was so obvious to me which one it was after looking at it. I don't know, something about being on the spot, I guess. Rewarding choice, interesting. And we're going to capture this place. pretty soon as well. They have a weak garrison, and I think if we make him a full 20 stack, we'll be able to just to start running through the jungle and taking what we want. Unfortunately, that will keep our hostility high, but... Oh, okay. I see how it is. The Temple of Kara has a garrison. She tried to hurt our Empire captain, I guess, and died. Ah, that's good. That would have been pretty annoying if she had hurt him or killed him. Alright, and they're besieging me. Okay. So we've got a lot of interesting choices to make now. Oh no. The Sword of Cain has been claimed. For those of you who don't know, it's like a static item in the game that spawns at one place to the north of Ulthuan, which is the big island home of the High Elves. And it's an incredibly powerful weapon that gives you all sorts of AoE abilities and combat abilities, but it ruins your campaign, basically. It gives you horrible public order and diplomatic relations and things like that. But who cares when you can beat any army in battle, right? So, oh, nice. They basically colonized this forest. That's beautiful. How strong is this army? Not strong at all. I'm pretty sure I can beat whatever they have here with this. But if they bring this army down too, I definitely cannot beat that. So, yes, interesting choices. And he... Conroy is feeling pretty badass because he was able to fight off and kill that guy. So let's go ahead and cross over and raid. And let's see if that triggers it. Or if we have to wait an entire turn. I hope not. So here's where things get a little bit tricky again. Oh my gosh, look how big the army has gotten in one turn. That's bull. Okay, let's just go take this from them.
Do your worst.
And of course we're going to auto-resolve this.
For the Empire.
There's some interesting units there to look at, but we don't really need to. Like, it'd be cool to see these savage orc boar boy biggins in battle, but not necessary. And we can occupy this. I don't know how well we'll be able to hold it. Picked up some more followers, picked up some more levels. I like hold the line a lot. So we still need lightning strike. I would love to get a logistician. But let's get lightning strike. We can repair this, why not?
Markus Wulfhart.
And hopefully they come to us. We still have regen. There's no way that's permanent. That's just too crazy. So all we had to do was raid an area belonging to the Vampire Coast, which I am pretty sure we're doing. Yep. So hopefully we'll get something next turn, because we're about to be attacked on multiple fronts. It might behoove me, if I don't want to lose the Temple of Kara, to drop an army here, even temporarily. A general of the Empire with Regal. Also not bad, but he's going to increase my upkeep to over my limit. I don't want to do that. I think we bought ourselves another turn before they both get here. And then from there we can try and get Aldebrass here as fast as possible. We'll drop in both of our regiments of renown, all the excess units that we have, and it'll be a pretty near full stack. Plus we're getting our supply drop in two more turns. Alright, so we did do it. Valhall's closes in. And he gained 3,000 experience from that, so he's up to rank 11 now. And I can't tell if they're going in a different direction or not. Interesting. Okay, tons of stuff happening. So, looters. Our armies consist of noble state troops, and yet they act like a horde of free company. They loot and pillage across the countryside. Something must be done. Alright, we're not going to be sacking anything anytime soon, so let's punish them and give ourselves +5 leadership. Alright, Valhall closes in. We'll read that in a second. We'll read that together. We finished our port, so that's cool. Yeah, it looks like maybe they're going to attack Chotek, maybe? With this stack? They've got some Blessed Chameleon Skinks, so this is a real stack. It's not a full stack, but it's a real one. And it looks like they left behind, yeah. They, like, totally abandoned this position. That's interesting. And we have two levels here now to aid us. So let's go with... Get Sigmar's Ward and let's get Assassinate. And do we have any... Okay, no, none of those that we need to... No followers that we need to equip. I think Markus is full. Yeah. So let's go over to Aldebrass and see if he could use one of these. We'll give someone on his side Strider and more Public Order. Alright, glad to do that. Now we can leave this place and go to reinforce somewhere. It's just, where do we go, you know? First things first, let's cross the line back into here. We want to wait until the last possible moment to recruit all of these units. We do not want to pay upkeep on this whenever we're barely positive right now. Because we're talking about adding like thousands, a couple thousand to this. And we need to be able to have quick victories to sustain ourselves before we get to that point. So let's move this way. This puts us in a nice position to reinforce either one of these cities. We can actually... Let's force march it a little bit. Get as much closer to these two areas as possible. And I'm kind of happy because all these guys are doing is colonizing the areas that we want to go to. He probably hurt the heck out of himself to do that.
Markus Wulfhart.
But can we not reach? I guess we can't reach him this turn. Interesting. It's almost like the AI knew that.
Markus Wulfhart.
But what we can do is, once again, we can try Markus and set up an ambush Wulfhart. Of some type.
The trap is set.
Don't know if that'll be successful, but it's worth trying. And then now Colonial Fort. So... Casualty replenishment rate is an extremely important thing for your campaigns. We've been struggling with maintaining Markus's units and their health for this entire time. And now it won't be as big of an issue. We'll be able to be more aggressive because we'll be able to replenish more units after every fight. Plus, we've been struggling to maintain public order. Tithe rebates plus Colonial Fort is a +3. That completely negates the... campaign malice of playing on hard difficulty. So that's what I'm looking to do, if you're curious. And I'm not really wanting to spend any additional gold anywhere. We need our gold to stay as high as it is. I really wish these guys would help me. Let's see if they will help us attack a particular army, perhaps. So like, if they came here and attacked this army, even if they lost, maybe they would soften them up enough to make things easier for us. So let's see if I've been messing things up. Let's also come over here and read. That was his. So let me read this with you guys. Make sure we read this one. Okay, he's looking for a particular vampire. And it says, I'm getting to know Air Doctor better. I've discovered that he is a most conflicted man. He is ruthlessly obsessed with destroying vampires, but is also a skillful healer with astounding convalescent skills. I felt I had built up enough of a rapport to bring him up the subject of his famous lineage once again. With a deep sigh, Hertwig explained his intense hate for the Von Hall name, for his ambition was always to preserve life and not to chase destruction. For him, the Von Halls would never be innocent of their progenitor's sins, and he wanted nothing to do with them. A man can try to avoid his destiny as much as he wants, he added. But in the end, it will always find him. He would elaborate no further. The next day, he invoked me to continue helping him with his mission to track down Alistair the Red. He says the best way to draw attention from a vampire pirate is to raid their lands and waters, so that is what we will do. It is certainly not without a touch of irony that we are probably about to steal from pirates. So, now we have to capture and occupy the Awakening, which is over here. It's a major settlement belonging to the vampires. That's a bit more difficult, but once again, it's going to proc an interesting choice, or a rewarding choice, as it's choosing to word it. All right.
Warrior
Was there anything else that we could do this turn? I don't believe so. So let's just end the turn, and we're gonna get some new supplies shortly. I may have to go for the steam tank this time, guys. We need some terror in our lives. I can't believe they think they can win this. Maybe they can with the leadership and the weapon strength, but I've got crossbowmen and pistoliers. Wish me luck, guys. I see us winning this. We just crossbow down the red-crested skinks and then, you know, play keep away with the Croxagore Lord. Yeah, I honestly don't see how we lose unless I'm really bad. So we want to buy time for pistoliers to do a little bit of work. So let's deploy a bit.
Swordsman! Awaiting orders.
A bit back. We really don't want them to get onto our crossbowmen. We can keep our crossbow formations kind of fat. There's no magic that's going to punish us. There's no cav that's going to punish us. All this does is let us have a better turning radius. The fatter your formation is. Normally you want to go in lines, but if there's very little chance that they can actually get onto them, then you're probably better off and leaving them in block formation. And here we go. And we just need to stay away from their range tools, not get poisoned, and buy ourselves as much time as possible. And of course, we can fire into 360 while moving. No reason to even kind of get ourselves in a bad situation. And you'll see here they're moving to counter skirmish. The only thing that sucks is that they could potentially poison us. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to keep microwing here. And if all we manage to accomplish here is to chase off all of these range tools and force them out of the fight, then we're doing a good thing. And you'll see how like we're confusing two units. They're not going to be part of the main engagement. Let's really focus the red-crested skinks. They are the greater danger for sure. All right. And now we can come back in and try and engage some more. We don't want to miss our charge bonus, but we want to get every single volley that we can.
For the Warhammer, destroy it.
And that Croxagore was happily getting in there. Alright, and they're not going to get any charge bonus on us.
No.
Alright, we missed one. But that's not the end of the world. And now we're going to go up and around and try and sandwich them. And these are standard skink skirmishers. These are not the chameleon skink, so they have no resistance to missile damage. Alright, pistoliers, fall back. They have a much shorter range. There's no reason to engage them like that. It's kind of bad. Keep going, spearmen. And these spearmen are shielded. Alright, back up.
Sigma, preserve us!
Get in there. Come on, guys. Prove the AI wrong. They're just so borderline unbreakable. It's crazy. Keep moving back. We've got to break all those little stacks. That's not giving them any chance there to just sit in melee. If he attacks one, we pull them back, and then we shoot with the other. Let's turn ourselves and face towards these javelineers with our shields.
State troops ready. Moving now.
Keep pulling back.
For the twin-tailed comet.
Keep pulling back. Let's go. We got plenty of ammo. We don't want to waste it. We can actually charge in here with two units in melee. We should be able to beat them. They don't have poison damage and melee. And they won't be able to shoot us once we close.
Fight them! Missiles
At some point, we're going to have to turn and shoot this Lord also. Alright, we got him. So now what we want to do is just chase him off. See if we can break him on the charge. Just about. They're wavering. Broken. Alright. You two need to get back in here. We're gunning them down. Don't know how much good it's doing. Get them in. Pull these guys back. And we'll pull them back in such a way that they can start helping us with this Croxagore. There's only 7 of these guys left. Can't believe how much trouble they're causing us. Alright, let's go over here and engage this Croxagore Ancient. Gator. Keep running. And we've put 2 crossbows on them. You know, let's get those spears there. Let's get the swordsman here. And now we'll just shoot him in the back. Very good. Go chase him down. And let's get this unit here doing this. Shooting them in the back. These 2 units should be able to beat these standard skink cohorts. You know what? Just in case, get over here and start shooting. Pretty good for him to be in the woods a little bit. It might block some of our missiles. Very powerful. We didn't really get a chance to look too much at this guy, but look how jacked and tan he is. He has monstrous strength, which gives him a bonus versus infantry. He has a potion of foolhardiness as well. Causes fear, of course, and he has a ward save of 15%. That's cheating, man. Did these 7 red-crested skinks come back? I can't even... And we'll engage there. And yeah, that should be army losses for him. He's got nothing left. And we want to do a ton of damage to him. We don't want to leave really anything left on the battlefield. Let's back up with our spearmen. All the damage we can do. But we're not going to kill him. Because I don't think his stack's going to be destroyed anyway. So let's just put him down to super low percentage. And that way he won't be able to attack us. He'll have to regenerate. Otherwise, they'll just get a free lord with full HP, and they might even attack us again. But yeah, pretty good defense. And this is basically what I thought would happen. It looks like we lost 1 group of spearmen, but they probably weren't completely wiped out. But yeah, man, that weapon strength and leadership, I can't say it enough. Be careful in your own campaigns how much you raise your hostility and how fast you do it, because... it's deadly. Pardon me while I drink a little water. Man, if we had killed him, I think we would have destroyed the whole stack. Now I have regrets. Please attack the temple. Ooh, maybe destroying his other stack made him rethink things. Or simply because we have Aldebrass here. He realizes he can't attack either without being wrecked by my reinforcements. Good plays, AI. You're putting pressure on me.
Those who make enemies of the Empire likely die by my arrow.
Alastra Direfin wants to give me some money for a peace treaty. I didn't even know we were at war. You are so insubstantial a threat that I will happily take 600 gold from you to have peace in a war that I didn't even know I was in. Alright, and our ally is doing something. And I guess they saw my ambush. Yeah, our ambush was foiled. Alright, my allies mobilized. They have 18 units here. I think they're going to get destroyed. But that is okay. That's okay. So our hostility has dissipated. But wait, it dissipated before I got my next supplies. What the hell? I was 1 turn away, I think, from getting the super supplies. Well, that sucks, unless I was misreading that somehow. It says here that it resets to zero after 5 turns, but I thought, okay. Well, this is actually great for us, because now we're just like, screw you guys. We're going to go in here and take all your stuff, because you no longer have unbelievable leadership, as if you're like Phoenix Guard.
Loyal or not, they'd better fight.
Lady's Mantle, missile resistance is kind of cool. Let's keep going towards Foe Seeker. Give him Deadly Blade. And I think we will try and... You know what? What are we going to build here? We've got gemstones. We've got... So, I mean, we have a lot of things covered. We can go for just straight up Weaving House. We're going to need as much gold as possible. Growth building there would also have been a good idea, I'm sure. And now look at this guy coming to fight. He's got Depth Guard.
True servant of Sigmar.
I will say this, though. You don't know nothing about my reinforcements. We can't attack him this turn, but we have to move towards him. And by doing so, we're going to leave ourselves vulnerable to counterattack.
The Empire.
All right, let's move this way. Might have wanted to try an ambush there. And just like that, we've got a decent stack. We could add in the Huntsmen. We could add in the Deathjack Archers and the Sigmar Sons. But I think that's overkill. They're not going to be able to muster up enough troops to fight us this turn. Our only real area of concern right here is Slaxlon. But I have to believe that we can hold this. The AI is just so bad at conducting sieges that if we get any kind of advantageous siege defense, like, I think we're going to win. But now we have a difficult choice of, do we attack this area with all of its savage orc biggins and tons of cav? And I think we do. We still have regeneration. Guys, there's no way that lasts forever. Normally it shows those types of buffs. Let's see, maybe they're down here. Yeah, turns remaining 3. Okay. Yeah, so we want to wipe these guys out while we still have regen. Oh my god. So, I'm very tempted here to auto-resolve. We could also lightning strike and totally remove the garrison. Which is why you get lightning strike. That takes out all of these biggins.
Let's get this done.
Yeah, let's lightning strike, guys. We've been fighting enough orcs. And we'll definitely do the climactic battle with them, the last army. Let us occupy, and they're going to run away. Probably should have just gone ahead and included them, that way they'd be dead. But this way we're going to get an extra battle out of it, which is more experience, more gold. I value that greatly. Alright, hostility has been increased, as expected. I'm glad that it resets after a certain number of turns, because it could definitely... I could see how it could be really, really obnoxious. And now we have unlocked his higher tier. Yeah, this is what we want to start putting points in. So best of the best, all recruits, +2. Would like to get hold the line as well. But best of the best, Paul Franz's captain of scouts is the very best in his field. A hunter truly without peer. And then next turn we'll probably get master survivalist. Or even more casualty replenishment rate. So we'll have like at least +20. And another 5% to our movement range is really important. And I like this increased, increase is not the right word, but increased percentage of decrease upkeep for huntsmen and archer units for our army, which is going to be good. And this double shot ammunition is also sweet. So, we'll see.
Traitors always get found out in the end.
More missile damage. And I know that you could cycle through guys, but sometimes it doesn't go to the units you want it to go to. It kind of like skips around in a weird way. So I prefer just to do it like this. And here I kind of just want to get Foe Seeker. Give ourselves another like nice speed boost in case we ever get caught. And then here for Hurtwig, give him more missile damage. At some point we can use him to start sniping heroes if we would
Markus
like.
Wulfhart.
Nice. And this already came with a garrison. Level 2. It's got a level 2 barracks for us. That's nice. Really just Pahwaks or whatever it is that we have to conquer. And kind of hope that they don't take this before we do. I feel like they can hold them back, but I asked them to do this. Let's actually... It's a toss-up. So if they come in here and win this battle, we'll be annoyed because, of course, they'll have our territory, which we don't want them to have. We want this port because owning ports increases our claim. And also, this is a four settlement territory that we want to have complete access to. But the odds are that they may lose this, but they do have a lot of chevrons. And they ultimately have a bigger stack, and this stack is quite hurt. Interesting. Let's see what happens. Let's roll some dice together. And I don't really want to upgrade this because I don't plan on making pistoliers or outriders. I don't think. But I need to stop the aggression from the east and the west. That way I can start moving south and secure these two places and here. So I want to start fighting on this front, but right now I'm kind of being forced to fight on this one. We could actually make a peace treaty with these guys. By killing them. Which sucks because I do want to destroy them. But if they were to pay me enough.
Yes.
You know what? I'll take it. And in many, many turns, when there's no one left alive that I care about, following Sigma. I am going to go and wreck you. So we're going to head in this direction. That frees us up a lot. Happy to be regenning here. Is there anything else I need to do? I don't think so. Roll. We're doing great, guys. Very curious to see where Gator's going. Also, guys, I wouldn't be surprised if the Vampire Coast gets taken out by someone else. Oh, wow.
It's war you have.
They brought down two armies. I wouldn't be surprised if they wanted to give us the full 3k. Nope. No, no peace. Just war. And without a doubt, they're sending this other stack to that other group. Oh, and here we go. So I think this will be the end of today's episode with this siege. We're going to do it, of course. We're going to quick save it. But I love going out on a high note. Let's see if I can hold this city. Let's hope I can hold this city. I hate that it's a double-sided fort. They have some really cool single-wall forts that I think we'd be able to hold amazingly. But we'll be able to see where they deploy. The problem is they have all these Pterodon riders. Which is kind of a problem, kind of not a problem. They're not an incredibly strong unit. But they do break the walls pretty well. And in that way, they're kind of a problem. So, alright, we've got two towers here with Saurus warriors inside of them and a bunch of units on standby to get inside. These towers are not going to be strong enough to destroy these towers. So what we need to do is hold the walls as long as possible. What I like to do first is I like to take all my range units, pull them off the walls. I like to group up wherever I think I need to hold the hardest. So like, I'll do something like this. Let's just put them there for now. Everyone else, let's just pull them off the wall to get them out of the way. We're going to use the Empire Knights as a bit of gate defense. So let's just go ahead and hot group them right now. So their job is to act like a bit of a hammer whenever someone gets through the gate. You know what? Let's do this. Let's go five there. Four here. So one spearman to sit here and one... Okay, they gotta be the right ones. Alright, let's make sure they have the right guys. Spearman to hold the gates if we need to. And if not, we'll just bring them up to the walls, guys. It's not a big deal. And then the swordsman. It's sometimes good to leave a single unit here in case units rout into your back line. But we need as many towers functioning as possible, so I think we're going to need them as well. But let's see before we get too ahead of ourselves. So we want here, and then he will help hold. Then let's go something like this. So we don't have to completely be inside of the box, but we need to be kind of close. This won't shoot at anything, so we don't need anything there. Yeah, we could just keep these halberds here just to reinforce anywhere on the front line, on the top here that we need it. Also, I don't think this tower will be able to fire at anything, so that's fine also. And now we just need to figure out where we want our crossbowmen. And sometimes it's best to put your crossbowmen here and then retreat them, or in the front lines on top of your walls. But I think what's going to be best here is putting them right here. There's not much space, though. You do something like this. The problem is they're going to come right over the wall and drop big rocks on top of these, like, tightly packed groups. You know what we're going to do? We're going to pull these two off. Put these guys there. Let's put one unit here. They'll be able to shoot up or into the gate if we need that. And then, I mean, that frees up quite a few assets for us. Extra units to plug up our defense. And then we'll keep this unit behind to shoot at them as they come through. So I think this is a pretty good solid defense. With a few more units, I would probably leave a very weak unit back here to do something. But with the Empire Knights, we should be able to reinforce any position that needs it. I think the Spearmen with shields will do a good job holding the gates. And yeah. So let's go, guys.
Soldiers of the Empire, form a ring of steel.
Take down some Pterodon Riders. I don't really care what we shoot at. We just don't want to waste time shooting at siege equipment. These are our really weak towers. And I don't, like I said, I don't think we can destroy them. Yeah, there's no way. So instead of wasting time shooting at them, you know what? Maybe we could destroy this one. If I had focused a little bit harder, maybe. But now it's a bit out of range. But let's shoot at the other guys. Are there Sauras back here? No, not really. Yeah, no more time wasted shooting at that. I don't think we can kill it. Kill the red-crested skinks. And they're being very reserved with these Pterodon Riders, but we're also not really able to do much damage to them. Not very strong walls, sadly. I thought they would advance a little bit faster, but they haven't.
We are Sigma's heirs.
I'm cool with this. Let's just shoot them up, and they're going to fight some swordsmen once they get up here. And up here, of course, we have halberds.
Halberdiers.
We have our charge defense. Definitely should have had these guys here. I don't know. That was a little bit of a miss. And you know what? I don't think they're going to make it to the gate. So let's get these spearmen up here. They're not going for the gate at all. Let's get our crossbow shooting into this blob. I think our art is good to hit them. They don't. Oh, yeah. That's perfect. They don't have shields. So that's what we need. And yes, tear them up. Okay. Let's back up here and put these guys here. It's a little buggy, but it'll work. And all of these units that are kind of in reserve, they can move up and start tightening up. Very good. Alright, they come in this way, and we need to shoot them that way. They broke down our gate. So for some reason, our halberds have decided to rush out. God, guys, sieges can be so terrible sometimes. Let's bring our spearmen to help there and put our halberds on the gate. These crossbowmen are still, like, completely unmolested, so we're gonna leave them alone. Come on, take them down. Get more swordsmen into the fight. And it looks like we're holding up here. I'm glad we decided to reinforce with these spearmen, because I think we would have been in trouble if we hadn't. And our Empire captain should keep them fighting.
Taking aim.
Okay. We can't really turn and shoot up here. That's not a thing. But let's get rid of all of these pterodons. Alright, bring the knights in. Let's go. What a limp, nothing charge. Gotta try and charge them straight on, or else they're not gonna get in the mix. Yeah, let's just hold them here. Continue getting whatever advantage we can through the towers. Shoot, guys, do something. Our halberds and spears are barely holding here. They're just fighting so much.
Spearmen, find them!
Missiles at the ready.
Still going, though. Ready, and as soon as we take out enough of these guys,
Sigma, guide our fire.
Yes, my lord.
We can reinforce.
For Heldenhammer. Find your
nope, don't do that. Nope. Guard for mode, guys, guard mode.
Steel.
We could perhaps get about right here, and maybe we can shoot in. Looks good to me.
Swordsman.
We've got plenty of swordsmen here to fight. The wall appears to be ours. This is the only area I'm worried, but we do have these Empire Knights here to help clean up anyone who leaves the wall. Alright, shoot, guys, come on. The huge, juicy blob here. And these are some healthy pterodons, so we need to focus them. Please tell me y'all can hit that. You know what? We need to bring some guys down. Let's go. And these other Empire Knights that are currently just chilling, I think we need them. So let's go. These crossbowmen are up to 114 kills. Truly, they are the sons of Sigmar that we need.
Sigma guides us. Crossbow ready, General.
Move back.
March.
I think we're almost done clearing the walls.
The Empire endures. Sigma preserve us. Our steeds are restless.
Come on, knights. I need you guys. Let's get in.
Swordsman.
Halberdiers are probably the real MVPs here. They're just like infinitely holding. And I like 2v1ing right now.
We're
moving super slow. Come on, get in.
Crossbows ready, General.
And you know what? This unit of crossbowmen, let's bring them over here so they can start shooting in the other direction. Get on them, get on them. And they're targeting the Croxagor only because I think they can hold him up for a long time. He has bonuses versus infantry and armor piercing, but he's definitely not the best at killing Cav. But we really want us to get the Halberdiers on him. Alright, let's get those spearmen down there. Let's send these guys back. What kind of range do we have? Come on, guys. Let's go. Is anyone doing that annoying thing where the AI comes and, like, captures your city because they routed into it? That's the worst. And we are out of ammo, so crossbowmen are going to engage in melee. Get up there. And this fire coming from here should be enough to kind of finish this for us, I think. Get in there, spearmen. And we're just leaving the Empire Knights in. the gate position is too awkward to like charge and counter charge and do get too fancy with it. These halberds want to get back in. We're causing rampage. We're finally doing a ton of damage with these crossbowmen. The fact that none of these units are shielded is huge for us. And these crossbowmen are going to make a pretty nice meat shield. They'll probably get some kills too, just because of how damaged the units are. And they're just holding them in place on the wall. James Von Sigurd, man, you are the hero we need, buddy. He's almost got 100. There he is, 100 kills. Boom. Dwayne the Rock Johnson. Get in there, halberds. Half these halberds weren't even fighting. Get in there, guys. For Franz, what are you doing? Let no man stand alone. Really just this Croxagore Ancient that's giving us some kind of problem right now. Can you shoot these units? I know we're like super close, but...
Formation, march!
Like, it feels like we can't get into a good enough spot to shoot them. Come on, guys. Try and shoot these red-crested skinks and we'll be in a great spot. More swordsmen. Let's come out here, swordsmen. And maybe we can get a nice sandwich attack. I was hoping they would use their own ladders. That would be cool. I don't think I've ever tried to do that. We're out of ammo again. So we'll go there. Yeah, that didn't work very well. We can fast forward a little bit here. This looks like a good position to shoot in. Come on, y'all have some ammo left? Shoot. There we go. Start killing them. More halberds, more swordsmen getting in on this oatmeal. God, I love the way he just punches people. Doing the Croxagore death roll. Alright, they've used all their ammo. Cycle you out of there. Like, y'all have got to be dead, right? Okay. Yeah, guys, a nice defense. I was watching a Turin stream yesterday where he had, like, this ridiculous siege battle that he did, but he didn't take it seriously, and the AI stomped him. It was so funny to watch, but I felt bad for him. It can happen to anybody. He ended up losing his Volkmar stack. And a siege that he could have easily won if he had just been, like, trying. Sort of hilarious. Spearman, let's get in there, guys. You got the anti-large we need. This thing is going to... Yeah, I was about to say, if he doesn't have over 200 kills yet, I'm going to be shocked. Because every time he swings, he gets 3 or 4 kills. Oh, my God. Take him out. We've got halberds, spears, swordsmen, empire knights. Don't let him in. Don't let him reinforce that Croxagore. There we go. Balance of power. You can see it's shifting very heavily in our favor. We'll just bring in the rest of our forces back to our holdout position. We're very crowded here. Back to fast forward. Can't believe this. He's going to fight to like 0 HP. He's going to get 300 kills. That's crazy. And these guys have been absolute troopers as well, grinding it out. Sending the crossbowmen to fight with the... to kind of inundate the swordsmen. Help them tank damage so that they can do the DPS. 24 HP he fought until. Unbreakable. Literally unbreakable. Can't believe that. Do they have some sort of buff that makes them unbreakable like that? They should not be fighting to the last man. Unless they have some ability I'm not aware of, or I don't remember. I should have to kill to the last man. Like, they should have run a long time ago. Interesting. I know there's a right that they can activate, You know what? Maybe because these units are the special... Maybe they were unbreakable. Did I have to kill every single one? I didn't even notice till just now. That whole stack might have been unbreakable. I might have to go back and rewatch that. Because that was the spirit of the four of the jungle or whatever, that special stack that came out whenever we reached full hostility. They might have had unbreakable. Awesome. Well, good to know. That was a free 1,000 gold for us, essentially. Enemy killed in battle. Nice. Faction destroyed. Very good. And just like that, guys, we're going to leave this for another day. Tomorrow, we're going to go ahead and take on this fight with the help of our allies. Completely unnecessary. And then we'll track down the last of... Man, Grievous Bootlicker has been super annoying for this campaign. Let's do a few last-minute kind of, you know, empire-building adjustments. We're going to come down here and try and resettle this area, and I guess we're going to come back and take these lands from them, if we can. Gator, of course, does not have what it takes. Let's keep keep rolling. We're going to head in a viscerally type direction. And yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching. Today was a fun episode. We accomplished a lot. And yeah, so I hope you stick around and keep watching. We've got plenty more to do. Soon, I'm sure, we'll take the fight to Mazdamundi himself. We'll be clearing out the jungle here and moving forward with our heroes' quest battles and stuff. So I look forward to that. Without any further ado, y'all, thank you so much for watching. Once again, my name is Brett. My channel is Goodtalk Gaming. If you're interested in joining a friendly Discord where you can play some Total War with other people, yeah, my Discord is great. The link will be in the description down there. It's Goodtalk, gentlemen's. And big shout out to everyone who is supporting the series. Has subscribed thanks to my Total War content. I appreciate you guys. And as always, y'all, I will see you in the next one. Feel free to leave any comments you want down below. What you think I could be doing better or worse. I don't know. if you know something that I don't know, I want to know it. So put it in the comment section. But alright, guys. Take care. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Later.